The statement that listed the new tariff said China wasn't responding to the $50 billion export level, so more exports needed to be included. The new list now covers that $200 billion figure in exports that will be evaluated for the next couple of months and then subject to a 10% tariff that could hit as soon as the end of August. The move is designed to tighten the screws. With the U.S. stock market, as we know, resilient, North Korea seems to be balking, and no near-term catalyst in talks with Beijing. A senior administration official yesterday said up until now, China has not been responsive at all. This new list now includes a dozen pages each for types of fish and construction materials. Also consumer goods like printer ink, baseball gloves, skis, handbags, and many categories of apparel. So the apparel and footwear industry wasted no time weighing in, saying that by including these items, quote, the administration has shown that it is not concerned about targeting the American public with its Trump tax, and said that if the administration continues to add tariffs, Congress should step in. Well, we should note Congress has not received the news especially warmly. The Senate Finance Chair Orrin Hatch said he supported the administration's moves on trade up until now, but he called this one in particular reckless. And then the statement from the Ways and Means Chair Kevin Brady said that the president should meet face to face with President Xi Jinping and solve all of these issues. Otherwise, Melissa, he said the result would be a multi-year trade war.
Kayla, you tweeted out the list of the goods, and the list is quite extensive and extremely specific. Do they seem to tilt more towards consumer goods, which would hit the U.S. consumer even more deeply?
Well, it's an extremely long list, Melissa. So on one hand, you do have some of those more obscure items like human hair and toilet water. But on the other hand, you have things like handbags, like leather goods, belts, things that consumers buy on a regular basis. And during the study of this $200 billion group of tariffs, you know, we asked senior administration officials, how exactly are you going to tailor and craft this list to exclude the consumer here? Because that had been the goal all along. And their answer was, well, the way that we're going to try to limit the impact on consumers, not by the types of goods, but by the fact that this is a 10% tariff and not a 25% tariff. So they're trying to game that maybe the price impact that ends up flowing through to the end consumer is lower this time around.
The retaliation, though, Kayla, is really what is feared in getting up to $250 billion in goods. We're getting to the point where China can't retaliate in terms of tariffs alone. The qualitative measures that they can take, the qualitative retaliation, is perhaps more concerning when it comes to, for instance, approvals for new business investment overseas or slowing down things along the supply chain that so many U.S. companies are dependent on.
That is true. And Kevin Hassett on this very program, Melissa, just a couple of days ago pointed out that yes, the U.S. sells a lot less to China than China sells to the U.S. And in fact, what the U.S. sells to China, most of that is made in China. So you can imagine that there are a lot of companies with manufacturing operations on the ground there that are worried about licenses. They're worried about health inspections. They're worried about passing certain labor tests that the government imposes. And we have seen the government not back down from imposing somewhat arbitrary restrictions on these businesses, whether they're U.S. businesses or South Korean businesses. It's a sort of regulatory blackmail, and some companies say that they're already feeling it. So certainly they have a lot of tools in their quiver, but the U.S. is gambling here that they have the upper hand.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.